In the last stream, we were working on trying to get to the end of Chapter 3, and we're pretty much there. We did the 48 Steel quest, we did the 1000 Buckets of Water quest, we upgraded our power, we now have a slightly upgraded magmatic dynamo producing approximately 240 redstone flux per tick, and between streams, the energy sacrifice quest has been completed. We've handed in 10 million redstone flux, so that now we have access to the Gods of a Tomb Smile Upon You, which is a smiley face quest that just wants us to tick the button. And as a reward, we unlock more recipes. Specifically, we unlock the recipe here for the Scarab. It says, demon ingots are obtained by throwing a gold ingot into a 1x1 lava pit with 5 nether bricks surrounding the lava on all faces except the top. So to make the Scarab egg, we need, of course, 4 demon ingots, 1 platinum ingot, 2 diamonds, and then a cobalt large plate. All of that, I don't think, is going to be too difficult for us. The platinum is the only bit that we don't really have just yet, but I'm assuming we can get that fairly easily. Yeah, we can get platinum from polished andesite. Do we have any platinum? I know we've done granite and diorite, but I don't think we've done, we haven't done any andesite just yet. And so we should probably get that going right at the start of today's stream here, because I have a feeling that much like the diorite and the granite before it, that we might need quite a bit of andesite here if we're going to get 16 platinum to make an ingot out of it. So we'll throw all the silicon dioxide into there. We'll also go ahead and of course grab even more nether quartz to get us even more silicon dioxide, and hopefully that will be maybe enough andesite. But while we wait for that to do its thing, let's see if we can't get those demon ingots. So if we're going to do that, we need some netherrack, which actually we just need nether brick. I was going to smelt netherrack for that, but we do not need to. We do of course have lava over in our portable tank here, so we can go ahead and just grab all of that. And all we have to do here, chat, is something a little bit... I think I'll dig it in the ground, I guess. I'm just thinking about like how we're going to build it. It looks something like this. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 nether brick. You have lava in the middle, like that. And then it should just be as simple, chat, as dropping some gold in there. Now, as I mentioned at the end of the last stream, I did spend a little bit of time between streams doing a little bit more mining in the deep dark, and then I spent a little bit of time processing all of the ores through the chemical dissolver and then through the chemical combiner, so that now we do have a couple of all of the ingots that I think we're going to use, iron, lead, copper, gold, tin, silver, and nickel. So hopefully we don't have to spend quite as much time today, processing our ores and creating a bunch of ingots. I feel like we spent a bit too much time doing that in the last stream. And so if we do 1, 2, 3, and 4, we should get, hopefully, 4 demon ingots. I feel like I might have lost one there into the lava, but that is fine. And as far as a cobalt large plate goes, that should also probably be fairly easy, actually, if we come over to our stencil table. And can I redo a stencil? You can. And so for now, let's just go ahead and like redo the tool rod stencil there to a large plate. And then if we put that in here with a little bit of cobblestone, we should be able to make a cobblestone large plate, which we can then of course use as a cast to make our cobalt large plate over in the smeltery. And I think we will be doing a little bit of work with Tinkers today, because I do very much so want to get and we should put some gold in here actually, but I do very much so want to get some armor, right? I've mentioned it for the last like 2 streams now, we've yet to actually get any armor outside of the slime boots, which have been doing a pretty good job at preventing us from taking fall damage, but I do not think that they are going to help us too much when it comes to actually fighting mobs. And if we look at chapter 4 here, the first quest is to kill 2 pharaohs. Now, I've yet to play with the Atum mod, so I have no idea how difficult it is to kill 2 pharaohs. However, there is some capitalized text at the bottom of this box. It says, be warned, this boss is very strong. So I feel like that might be a slight warning that maybe we should look at getting some decent armor and potentially a slightly better weapon than this obsidian rapier that we've been using up until now. You do need 8 material here to get a large plate, so I think we are going to have to put 4 cobalt in here. That should get us 8 cobalt ingots in the smeltery, which then should get us the cobalt cast, at which point I think we should be pretty much good to go. I have a feeling we're probably not going to need this much andesite. Like, I imagine we need a couple of stacks, but I doubt that we need, 18 stacks of andesite to get 16 platinum. Yeah, I feel like we've definitely ever so slightly overdone it with the polished andesite. But there we go. There's 19. Nice. So we'll put that in. We'll go ahead and stop this, I guess. Save our silicon dioxide for later. We do get silicon dioxide back, of course, when we run the andesite through here, as well as, you know, iron and aluminium oxide and all kinds of other stuff that we can use in the future. So it's not necessarily a waste, but if we go ahead and unlock, throw in the platinum, I think we're pretty much good to go, right? Over here, how is our cobalt doing? It's very almost there. We'll go ahead and pull that out. And there we go. There's our large cobalt plate. So I think, Chad, that we basically have everything it takes here to make the scarab, right? We do. Nice. Look at that. And that, I believe, basically unlocks chapter 4 for us. We get 32 bread, which is not particularly useful, but nice to have nonetheless. And then it says, Atum, land of the sands. Create the Atum portal and enter. To build the portal to the Atum, make a flat 5x5 layer of sandstone. Make a square ring of sandstone on top of the previous layer. Make 2 block tall pillars of sandstone on top of each corner of the ring. Fill the center with water. Toss the scarab in the water. Okay, so we need quite a lot of sandstone, at least 25, and then, you know, more for the next layers. So it looks like we should once again re-engage our silicon dioxide here to make more sand. Hopefully that is enough. And then I don't know where we're going to build this. I guess we'll build it like over here for now, maybe. I don't think it really matters too much where we build it. But if we do something... Oh, this is broken, eh? If we do something like this. So we have the first 25 sandstone, and so we can kind of do this like bottom 5x5 platform here. And then we need enough to do another ring. So that's what, 5, 10, 16. And then we need 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 32, 23, 24, I think, more sandstone. If my arithmetic adds up there. All right. So that should be enough sandstone here, I think. So if the quest book is to be believed, I think we're doing something like this. It said a square ring, which I assume is on the outer edge like that. And then on the corners, it said a 2 tall pillar. And then fill the middle with water. I assume, again, that it means fill this bit with water, not fill like the whole area up here with water. Again, we are shy on buckets, but we do have this reservoir here, so we should be able to come on over. And I think we can fill it up directly out of the aqueous accumulator there. That does give us 8 buckets worth. If we then do, that takes us up to 9. And so that should be enough if we switch back to empty mode here. To do that. And then if we throw in the scarab, it worked. We got an ominous sound and we have a tomb, land of the sands. Okay. So first question, chat, if I go through this portal, can I come back easily? Yes. Okay. I have no idea what to expect. Okay, so it's kind of like a standard overworld-looking world, but very much so just Deadwood Forest in the top right there. Okay. I do see some guys over there. If my Minecraft knowledge has taught me anything, it's that enemies, or like just NPCs with swords, are usually not to be messed with. They're usually hostile right out of the gate, so I'm not going to bother with those guys too much. We do have strange sand here, which I assume is interchangeable maybe with regular sand. Yeah, it says all dictionary entry sand, so you can use that as sand. So, like I mentioned, I think before we start with chapter 4 here, which we have now unlocked, we've completed all of the quests in chapter 3, and I will definitely take the chicken sandwiches, the stone torches, and the Anubis Mercy. What the heck does this do? Soul Pact. When you die, you will keep your equipment and your active items. Sure. Like I said, I think before we start, though, with chapter 4, we might want to get some better weapons. It says, kill 2 pharaohs. Occasionally in a tomb, you will find pyramids. At the bottom of them will be a sarcophagus. To find the pharaoh inside, place a lit royal torch on the 4 corners around the sarcophagus, then right-click it to initiate the fight. Be warned, this boss is very strong. Okay. Royal torches. These are very easy to make. It's 1 gold and 1 coal gets you 4 royal torches. So we can get that going fairly easily. I don't think I see any pyramids, although maybe this is a pyramid over here. Yes, that very much so looks like a pyramid. Okay. So it said you have to get to the bottom of the pyramid. I can't break that, eh? Oh, hello. I don't like the way you're walking at me. You sound like villagers as well, which is very, very disturbing. I'm going to head back, chat. Ooh, there's some surface lava as well. Interesting. I'm going to head back, and we're going to do two things. I think the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to set up the mob spawner that we talked about a little bit at the end of the last stream. We did two quests up here. We got the evacuumulator, and we got our first drop of evil, and so it really shouldn't take us too long to get a pretty decent Cursed Earth mob farm up and running. And then after we get that, I think we'll look at upgrading both our Tinker's weaponry and our Tinker's armor. Once we have that, then I think we'll head back through and we'll see about fighting those pharaohs. So if we're going to get a Cursed Earth mob farm, I think what I will do is I think I'll set up like a little 5x5 Cursed Earth mob farm. So do we have any gravel? We do. We can use the gravel, of course, much like we've been doing in the past to make coarse dirt. And then we can use that coarse dirt to get more regular dirt. And like I said, I think we'll go with a fairly small Cursed Earth farm. From my experience, you really don't need a massive Cursed Earth farm to get a lot of drops, especially over time, right? This thing will be running like 24/7, so we can kind of just set it up and let it do its thing. I also do believe we were given a builder's wand, right? That might also make this a little easier here. If we take that and then use it to place down all of the dirt, all the coarse dirt, that is. Nice. So let's build this, like maybe just a little further away here, mostly because I think it's going to be a little loud. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then we'll use the wand, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, I think ideally, I kind of want to use some darker glass here. So the way it works, by the way, is you take your drop of evil and you right click it on the dirt that then turns the dirt into cursed earth. And if the cursed earth is fully dark, it will start spawning mobs. So the idea for us is that we're going to get the cursed earth going. We're going to use vector plates along the top of the cursed earth because mobs will still spawn on the vector plates, but the vector plates will then push the mobs towards their death. For that, I think we're going to use spikes from extra utilities. I don't think we quite have enough diamonds. 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 plus 6 is like 18. We might actually have enough diamonds if we wanted to go with diamond spikes. Diamond spikes, I think, are the fastest. Like, they deal the most damage. And also, they do allow you to get player-only kill items. So you can get specific items that normally you wouldn't be able to get. We do have 20 diamonds. And they are fairly easy to come by in the deep dark, especially with our vein miners. You know what? I think we might go for the diamond spikes. I'll bookmark those. And we'll come back to them in a second. And then the final piece of the puzzle is how do we want to actually make this room dark? And I think for that, I'd like to use dark glass. Dark glass allows us to see what's going on inside of the mob farm, but doesn't allow light to pass through into there. So to make dark glass, we need thickened glass, which is sandy glass smelted, which is made from sand and glass. So we need a lot of sand. Thankfully, we have just unlocked a sand dimension, so getting a lot of sand shouldn't be a problem. And then we also need black dye. Thankfully, I believe we can use charcoal. Yeah, pulverized charcoal is an option there. And of course, we can turn our coal into carbon, or our wood into carbon, or our diamonds into carbon, and then use that carbon to make charcoal fairly easily in the combiner. And we might even be able to make charcoal dust directly. We can't. We only have to pulverize the charcoal, but I think that's fine. So I think we'll start by repairing our stone mattock and then heading through to the sand dimension, which is also known as a tomb, because I think what we'll do is we'll just vein mine or excavate out a large amount of sand, bring that back, smelt up a little bit of that sand into glass, and then see if we can't make some dark glass. We really don't need a ton of it. There we go, perfect. So that gets us like 2 stacks of sand. And we can just slash home to get away from this guy. We don't have to mess around with the portal, I don't think. Oh. So smelting strange sand gets you crystal glass. Can I use crystal glass to make dark glass? It looks like the answer to that question is no. So that is unfortunate. We can, of course, run the strange sand like through our dissolver. I can't run it through the dissolver. Oh, that's very interesting. You can run the crystal glass through the dissolver, but you can't run the strange sand through the dissolver. Okay, so unfortunately, we can't use this strange sand to make glass. I think we might still be able to use it. Wait, can we use it to make thickened glass? Yeah, we can still use it in the crafting recipe for thickened glass because it counts as sand. But we are going to have to use regular sand to make glass. Okay, that is completely fine. While we wait for that to smelt up, if we're going to get into Tinker's Armory, I do believe that we're going to need the Armor Forge, which is made in a very similar way to the Tool Forge from Tinker's Construct. It is 3 seared brick, 1 armor station, which we can make fairly easily here with a crafting table and some blank patterns, both of which we should be able to get fairly easily. There we go. And then the final piece of the puzzle is 4 blocks of basically any metal. And I think we are going to go with iron because we do have 138 iron ingots here. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And we might also want to get a Tool Forge as well for some better weaponry. But for now, the Armor Forge is good to go. And I will throw this down kind of over here with everything else. So this allows us to make our helmets, our chest plates, our leggings, and our boots. All of which are made with a helmet core, a chest plate core, legging core, or boot core. And then you need armor plates and armor trim. So I think we're going to make our cores out of manulin. I was looking through the chest plates here. If I type in chest plate, you can see they all have a defense stat and a toughness stat. And manulin is quite high, but steel is also higher. Steel has a defense of 22.08 and a toughness of 5.4, which is slightly higher. So I think what we might do is maybe have like a manulin core with like steel plates or steel trim. And I think you do get the most benefit by making the 3 different parts of the armor piece out of different materials, right? So we could make it all out of manulin, but I think we can get a better piece of armor if we do like manulin steel and then like cobalt, or manulin steel and like electrum, or, you know, just some kind of third piece of material to get that extra, you know, bonus effect. If we're going to use steel, we should start putting some iron over here. We do also need this charcoal to make dark glass, but that's also going to allow us to get steel to then, you know, make more armor. So let me do a little bit of research here. So we can make the stencils for the armor over here. And if we're going to make our armor out of things like steel, out of manulin, out of cobalt, we are of course going to have to make yet more casts. So let's grab like at least 6 stencils. We need 1 for the helmet armor, the helmet chest plate, leggings and boot core, and then 1 for the plates and 1 for the trim, right? So blank pattern. Let's get, we'll go for 8 of course, because you make them in sets of 4. And then over here, actually, quick detour. People did mention that we do have the Gluttony Charm in the pack, which is a fantastic item that is not too difficult to make. It does require some wheat. Thankfully, we do have seeds. And so I'm going to take a quick pivot because I'm going to get this Gluttony Charm because it is fantastic. We only need 3 wheat, so we should just be able to grow up 3 wheat fairly quickly here. That took longer than I thought. But once we have all 3 wheat there, I think we're pretty much good to go. So we'll make a regular golden apple, which of course we don't have, but we can grab that aforementioned cellulose and sucrose, both of which I think we should have, right? No, that is wishful thinking. I think we should have some sucrose. Yeah, we've got quite a bit of it. And then cellulose we could of course get from like some oak maybe. Also wishful thinking, but I think maybe you can get it from this. Yeah, you can. Nice. Okay. So I'll take you over here. Let's do apple. Boom. And boom. We only need the 1, but 3 is fine. And then if we go ahead and craft up a golden apple, that should be everything we need, chat, for the Gluttony Charm. And the benefit of this is that you can wear it in the bobble slot here, and it just makes you eat your food faster. So look at that. We ate that cooked apple there super quickly. The cooked apples, of course, do a ton of hunger. This is obviously a lot better with items that do kind of less hunger that you have a lot of. So for example, we could eat, I think, a bunch of beets very, very quickly, thus kind of giving us the same effect of the cooked apples, which is very nice indeed. For now though, let's pivot back over to the stencil table here, and let's get the helmet pattern, the chestplate core, the leggings core, and the boots core, as well as the trim and the plates. For now, we'll put all of those into the pattern chest, because we can then access those, of course, from the part builder over here. We do need to make at least a cobblestone version of each of those, I think, if we're going to make them out of, if we're going to get casts for them. And I think we might need a little bit more cobblestone, maybe. Yeah, I'm not quite sure how much cobblestone each piece takes, but we do have our Devnil on us, and so getting that cobblestone is not going to be a problem. You do want to leave at least 1 cobblestone in there, though, otherwise it won't do its job. So we just need leggings here. Nice. And then we are, of course, going to need to get 8 gold in the smeltery. in order for us to be able to make the casts. Cool. Once again, let's do a quick check on how we're doing with Dark Glass. I think we're not doing particularly well because all of our pulverized charcoal has been turned into steel. If I wanted to make 4 steel plates, how much steel would I need? Quite a bit. So each armor plate requires 3 steel ingots. So if we want to make 4, we'd only need 12 steel, actually. How much steel do we have? We have 7, right? 9. Okay, it's going up. We are pretty close, though. So I'm going to take iron out here. I'm going to leave just enough to make 12 steel, because I think that's going to be enough. If we want to make all of our cores out of manulin, that is quite a bit of manulin. Each of the cores require different amounts of material. So we need 6 plus 4 is 10, plus 5 is 15, plus 4 is 19. So we need 19 manulin. I believe that 1 cobalt and 1 ardite gets you 1 manulin. So we need 19 cobalt and 19 ardite. They do double, of course, in the smeltery. And so I believe that if we just put in 10 cobalt and 10 ardite, that should get us 20 manulin, which will be 1 manulin more than what we actually need here, which I think is perfect. So we'll also go and get all of those in here as well. Yeah, I will make a new patent chest here, because that extra patent chest is going to allow us to store all of our casts over by the smeltery, which I think is very much so going to help us out in the long run. So if we take this and kind of put it down over like here, we can then start putting casts in like that. And speaking of the casts, let's go ahead and make all of these, shall we? And once we have all 4 of the casts here, it should just be a case of pulling out all the manulin, right? Which we should, if my math is correct, have just enough of, like just a little bit more than enough of, actually. We can also go ahead and take the pulverized charcoal now and craft that with the thickened glass, like so, to get a bunch of dark glass. I think 45 is what I said we were going to need there, so we are going to need just a little bit more in the way of thickened glass, but again, that really shouldn't be too much of a problem here. Do we have more thickened glass? We do indeed. Perfect. And so once again, if we do this and this, and that takes up to 50. Nice. So that should be more than enough, and we're going to do that in just a second. Let me finish up the casts here. We'll put the casts away kind of as we use them. So we've done the leggings. We still need a chest plate, and we still need a helmet as well. Again, actually, I guess what we should also do is grab the 12 steel and throw that in here as well, because while we're at it, we should probably also go ahead and make the cast for the other part that I've forgotten the name of, this guy right here, the armor plates. So yeah, we're going to have to make one more cast for the armor plates. We're then going to turn all the steel into steel armor plates. We're then going to have, hopefully, all of the cores, all the armor plates, and then the only thing we have to figure out after that is what we're going to make all of our trim out of. And right now I'm kind of leaning towards maybe cobalt, because according to the book, which is like Materials and New Armor Addendum, you can get a speed bonus, like a movement speed bonus, a small one, but a speed bonus nonetheless from cobalt. So I am quite interested in making that happen. That's not what I want to do at all. I want to put the trim in. That's fine. We can melt the cast. Only we can't melt the cast back down, right? That's not a thing you can do. No, it's not. That's very annoying. We can maybe use it for a reinforced modifier later on down the line. All right. So yeah, we'll pull out all of the steel, I guess, as well. And then we'll do the final cast, which I believe is the helmet one, right? Yeah, we've got the helmet core cast as well. Thankfully, these steel armor plates are quite quick to melt down here. And I guess, yeah, we might as well come over here, grab the trim. And thankfully, there's not a separate trim for like each and every armor piece. It's just one centralized trim. And I guess we'll put 2 more gold in there for that final trim cast. And then if we're going to make... How much do you need for trim? What's the material cost associated with the trim? It is 1. So we just need 4 more cobalt, which is just 2 more cobalt ore, which again, really shouldn't be a problem, actually. Yeah, that's completely fine. Nice. If we go and look at that materials and you book here, the one specifically about the armor, it does mention... all of the materials that you can, you know, make. You can click on any material here. We can see Manulin, for example, has a defense of 20. It's vengeful. It says your attackers might not feel great after hitting you. And you can see it has like a durability of 19.7. And you can see all the modifier slots and whatnot associated with each material if you'd like. And on top of that, if we go back to the front page here, there are also modifiers and accessories that we can put on to our armor. So, for example, we can add redstone to our armor to increase our movement speed by a small percentage, but you can stack multiple levels of redstone on there to move even quicker. There is resistance, which reduces damage from all attacks. That seems very useful. And we can make, I guess, maybe a few of those. Resistance, how hard are those to make? They are not too bad. They do require a lot of iron. But other than that, they're basically the same as the reinforced modifiers, just obsidian and casts. So that's not too bad. There's blast resistance. There is fire resistance, which could be useful. We have fallen in lava quite a few times, and reducing damage from lava seems like it could be quite useful for us. And you can level that up a few times as well. Projectile resistance. Emeralds and diamonds give you kind of just like small stat boosts. And there's quite a few, actually. There's quite a few options here. And then accessories-wise, we do have the night vision goggles, which I think we're definitely going to want to install. So there's quite a bit we can do here. There's quite a lot of customizability available. Let's go ahead and pull out the four trims. All right, that should be four trim. Nice. So hopefully, chat, now back over at the armor forge, I think we can make this. So we can do like helmet, trim, and plate. And that gets us a helmet with a defense of 24 and a toughness of 5.4. Three modifiers, and that bonus speed there is from the cobalt. We do have Indomitable from the steel as well. Make sure armor more effective. Nice. So we'll go ahead and take that. We'll then do the same with the chest plate, as well as the leggings, and of course, the boots. And look at that for an ensemble. That is quite something. We don't have the slime boots there. I think there is a way to make slime boots, but it might be the case that we have to like replace. I don't know if we necessarily need them. They are quite nice, but I think we can work without them. Like we can take, you know, we can take more fall damage now, I think, due to the fact that we have the armor. I think if we wanted to, we could have made the boot core out of slime, and that would have given us that bouncy buff there. And then we could have done the rest, you know, still out of steel and cobalt. And that might have been worth it. And it's possible, you know, that wasn't too hard to make. I might go back and swap those out potentially. Although I guess maybe you can just swap them out instantly. Does that work? Let me try something here. Can I do this and then this? I totally can. That is going to take down our defense by a order of magnitude. It would take our defense from 24 down to 2.4, which is a huge dip. It does increase our durability ever so slightly, but that it does add the bounce effect, which I believe is identical to what we have with our current slime boots. Our armor is still pretty good. You'll see like at the bottom here, we still have a lot of armor even with, you know, without the boots. What I think I might do, chat, is I'm going to not do it just yet, because what I think we'll do is we will go and fight the Pharaoh. And then once we fought the Pharaoh, I don't know if there's much more combat in the pick. Like I don't see any of the quests just yet that like require combat. So I think I might go and fight the Pharaoh with our current armor set. And then we'll come and we'll make it weaker with the slime boots after the fact, because then we can continue to fall down in the deep dark and whatnot. But before we get carried away, let me dump some of my stuff out here and let's get this mob farm up and running. So my idea here, chat, is to have, I think, a 3-tall mob farm. I don't think we can have like any mobs that are going to be more than 3-tall. I'm pretty sure Enderman spawn in the 3-tall box. I think I will go with the diamond spikes. Again, the diamonds, not going to be too difficult for us to come by. We actually do already have one of the diamond swords there, so we can use that as well. So if we want to do that, we need to get two more diamond swords. So we'll get sticks. And we'll do one and two. And at that point, that should be those pretty much taken care of. It is indeed. And I think what we might do here, chat, is I might have all of the mobs kind of pushed into a corner, as opposed to being pushed into, like, normally what I would do is I would have them pushed to like a point, like right here. But given that we're gonna get like spiders, I think what we might do is kind of get rid of these bits, put down our diamond spikes here, and that way the mobs will kind of be pushed over in this direction and then fall onto these spikes. I will also, of course, use a solid block around the edges here to fully make this dark. For now though, let's do this. And I guess actually before we fully fill that in, let's go and get the vector plates, of which we need, I think, 21. So they do require more slime, which we do not have now, but we can of course make with the protein and the sucrose that we just put away. And one slime gets you 8 vector plates. You really don't need too much. We do need some sugarcane. It does pain me greatly to tear down our sugarcane, which is getting exceptionally tall. I think that goes all the way up to like build height, which is insanity. But I believe that should be pretty much everything that we need in order to make the vector plates here. Yeah, 24 is more than enough. And so, yeah, I think what we'll do is we will have vector plates. And if you hold shift, by the way, you don't get affected by vector plates. But we'll have them just kind of push over in this direction and then down towards the spikes. Like that. So now if a mob spawns in, it'll be slowly pushed over into the spikes. I'm not going to stand on them because I will die. Well, it'll take a while, actually. It's probably a good idea to test our armor out. Our armor's pretty good. I think these spikes are quite powerful. Also, excuse me, do you level up your armor by taking damage? Like, we have XP 16 out of 100 there. That's interesting. But either way, that should work. Just as a test. I know this looks horrible, but I'm going to put some sand here just to make that fully dark. And actually, we do, of course, also need to get our drop of evil under there. I am fairly certain you can do this through the vector plates. Like, I think we can just get rid of like this vector plate here and then right click with the drop of evil. Yeah, we totally can. That did turn all of the dirt to cursed earth. And then if we cover this up, we should be good to go. Now, how do I do this? Again, we will re-evaluate this when we get some more, you know, nice looking building blocks. For now, though, I am going to just put a cobblestone roof on this thing, which is going to look bad, I'm aware. But like I said, it's a work in progress. And as soon as that becomes dark, we should start seeing mobs spawn in. I will get rid of the cursed earth that's on the outside here. And yeah, there we go. Look at that. So the creeper spawns in, he gets pushed over, he dies, and we get his wares. So the only thing we have to do now is grab our vacuumulator that we made previously. And I'll plop that down facing towards where the mobs die. So I think we'll just do this and we'll use the crescent hammer to rotate it. Like that. And that should pick everything up. Now, of course, in the long run here, we're probably going to want to connect that up to like some storage drawers. And in the really long run, we probably want to connect it up to like our main storage drawer network. So in hindsight, I probably should have built it like behind the drawers. Like if I'd have built it over there, that would have probably been much better, because then we could have just run like an item conduit from here to the draw controller, and we could have added a few more draws to the setup. But this does work, and we do get extra loot crates here as well. Helium light. Interesting. That looks pretty cool, actually. I assume it does work as a light as well, which is pretty neat. And we get so many loot crates, chat. We might get like quite a lot of elements just from those loot crates. For now, all I'm going to do to make sure this doesn't back up is I'm going to pump things over into a chest. I do believe that we have the iron chest mod installed. I think I saw a chest upgrade earlier on down the line. Yeah, we do. So we could, if we wanted to, make, for example, like an iron chest, and then from there make a gold chest, and then a diamond chest if you really want to. But I think for now, a gold chest will probably do us. And then if we use an item duct, and I think that's actually fine. Normally you'd use a servo, but I'm fairly certain that the vacuumulator can auto-eject. So if we just do like this and this, make sure you're set to auto-output enabled at the bottom, that should push all of the drops over into here. Not a permanent solution. This will fill up eventually. But like I said, we'll potentially look at getting some storage doors here. We could, if we wanted to, run a really long item duct over to the draw controller. I might do that. I also might, between streams, look at going and getting like another drop of evil and just moving this whole thing over behind the drawers there, because I'm not a huge fan of where we put that. But we could also just move the drawers, right? That's also something we could do. If we get some packing tape, we could pack all this up and move that fairly easily. That might be the easier way to do it. For now, though, I guess let's see if we can fight this pharaoh. We probably do want to get a better sword, because our current rapier I don't think is going to cut it. The only reason we'd make a new one is if we weren't going to put nether quartz on the new one, right? because if we just replace the parts here, we get the benefit of already having leveled it up. So I kind of feel like we probably are going to put, and like if we're going to put quartz on a new one, we might as well just upgrade this one, right? Yeah, I feel like upgrading this one might be a bad idea. What is the material cost for a saw blade? It's 2. Did we have 2 manulin left over here? We got 1 manulin left. Okay. So I think the best, I was going to say the best sword we can make is manulin, but I think actually the best sword blade might be demon ingots. That has an attack of 11.1 versus manulin's 8.72. Yeah, so I think it's probably actually more worth it for us to do something like this and use those as our new sword blade. So that takes our attack damage up to 9.71. And still leaves us with 3 modifiers as well. So I'm being recommended maybe like a bone tool rod. Durability is in the drain though. Yeah, our durability is 96, right? It's not crazy good. If we don't use any more modifier slots, we can, you know, level this up twice and get to 5 modifier slots, at which point we could put in reinforcements. We could add reinforcements before we do that as well, just to increase the durability as well. We can also throw like a diamond on there and that could increase the durability a bit. So let's get a new tool rod cast. And then let's make a bone tool rod here. And then how does that help us over here? That takes our attack damage up even higher and does boost the durability quite a bit. Your tool's damage is increased. Okay, I like it. I like it. And then we could add like a diamond modifier. And we could even, if we wanted to, add like an emerald modifier as well. I think the diamond modifier, I think it's one of those things where the diamond modifier, I think, adds a flat amount of durability, right? Is that correct? Does it add 500? It does. It adds a flat 500 durability, which is pretty massive, actually, given our current durability. It, you know, increases it like fivefold. The emerald, I believe, gives it a percentage-based durability, so we could add a diamond, then an emerald to get even more durability, but I think this is honestly probably fine. And then from there, the question just becomes, do we want to use those final 2 modifiers to pump like a bunch more quartz on it? Or do we want to put like some redstone on there or something? We could put like 1 lapis on to give it looting. It's already pretty fast, but it could definitely be faster. Looting would be good, but I think we can wait on looting. I don't think there's anything that the pharaoh's going to drop that we need like a ton of. Right now, I'm just looking for some zombie pigmen, by the way, to test out my new sword on. But yes, I think we could, like when we level up again, we are going to get another slot. So I think we can add looting later. Or maybe like make a separate sword for looting endeavors. Hello, my friend. That's not right. Hello. Okay, so that is quite good, actually. We're killing those guys pretty fast. But I do feel like a little bit of redstone could go a long way, because I can definitely click faster than this can, you know, do its thing. So I think I will add 1 of our modifiers here for redstone. Yeah, we'll bump that. We'll go all the way up to 50. So, chat, I've cooked up some more apples. Or I'm cooking up more apples. We have our sword here. Not the craziest sword in the world, but I think it's going to be pretty good. And we have our armor as well. We do have still slots on our armor. We could, if we wanted to, add, you know, yet more stuff to it. For example, we could take some redstone here and make us, I think, a little bit faster if we wanted to. You know, if we take, like, our leggings, for example. Although I'm pretty sure you can put it on any slot and, you know, get another bonus 5% to speed. Oh, yeah, you can definitely feel it as well. And we do look even cooler with that little red, red like, skirt that we got going on there. I like it. I like it. So, yeah, I'm not convinced. Like, the book does say, in all caps, this boss is very strong. However, the Twitch chat has convinced me that the boss is not that strong, that I need to worry about more upgrades to my armor. We do still have a lot of modifier slots, so we can add even more. But yeah, unfortunately, we don't have enough redstone to add even more. Otherwise, I would. But yeah, let's go give this a try, shall we? Now, let me grab the last of my apples here. There we go. I think 29 should be enough. We can, of course, eat them very quickly, and they do provide a lot of durability, a lot of saturation. So let's see, how fast can I kill you? Pretty quickly. I don't know how strong those guys are, or if that's like, you know, anything that's worth celebrating. But these guys are pretty easy, and our armor does seem to be holding up fairly well here. There are a lot of them, which is less than ideal. Like, I kind of want to get into this pyramid, guys. Apparently, we have to find the entrance to the pyramid. I have no idea where that might be. Is it at the top? I do hear what sounds like mobs inside of the pyramid. You have to dig into the sand. I thought I tried that. It didn't work. Like, we can't dig into the limestone bricks. Dig into the sand? Like, down here? It's buried in the sand. Oh. I see. Getting a lot of chests. I'm not gonna lie, chat. I'm not loving the sounds that I'm hearing here. Oh. It goes real far down, eh? Is it like on one of the sides that I've not found yet? It's on a different side. So you've got to check all four sides. So I believe this is the entrance. Okay, I do have torches. Before I head in there, let me get rid of like all of the trash that is filling my inventory right now. In fact, I guess we can just do this up here, right? I can just go ahead and dump all of that up there, as opposed to putting it onto the floor. That's fine. Let's go. Let's go check this out, shall we? So we do have torches, and I feel like I should definitely be deleting these spawners. Like, if push, oh my goodness, if push comes to shove, we can always go ahead and get, like, find another pyramid, right? To get more of these freaking bone blazers that are here. Gosh, they make a horrendous sound. All right. That's level one done. It would appear there is a spawner down. Oh, we're like, oh, it's like a freaking maze, dude. Okay. I don't know if it's a maze or like a narrow pathway. That's a dead end. That's a dead end. Ooh, okay. So we do have to watch out for traps. Can I? How does one? Can I not break these? Right click the traps. Oh, right click with the pick. Okay, I see. So we can right click these with our pickaxe. There's quite a few of them, eh? To shut them off. Hello? Okay, no one in there. I have come here, chat, without the torches, I do now realize. Thankfully. We do have a nifty little command that allows us to get back and forth very easily. So royal torches, let's get... we don't even have any charcoal, of course. We've been using all of our charcoal to make steel and whatnot. So let me get carbon. Let's get like one bit of charcoal going here. Regular coal would also have worked. And let's try that again. Perfect. All right. So this is the sarcophagus. Oh, there's a trap. We do have to kill two of these. I don't know if that means finding a second pyramid or if there is like two in the one pyramid. But to be honest, the pyramid wasn't too bad. Hello. Oh, Okay, so this man is not quite as strong as the book makes him out to be. Or maybe he is, and we've just got like very powerful weaponry. But that was not too bad, actually. That was actually completely fine. So let's get these torches back, because we do need to go and find another sarcophagus to try this again. Chat was correct, and I did not need to upgrade my armor for this. We got 6 dirty coins. I think we needed 20 for this quest. Yeah, I'm not quite sure we're going to get all those from, but who knows? Helium lights and obsidian breakers. Okay. Loot crates and the sarcophagus. Oh, there's like a... Oh, I see. So there is like there's stuff in the sarcophagus here. A tomb's will. When fully charged, deals double damage. Oh, okay. I'll take all of that, I guess. It's a lot of... I'll leave the limestone and stuff here, because I don't know if we're going to need that. Actually, I think the limestone might be needed for the brown antimatter, right, now that I mentioned that. Yeah, you get neodymium from limestone, so I very much do need the limestone. That's fine. So, is the other guy going to be, like, in here? The answer would appear to be no. There are chests here that I've kind of been leaving. They don't appear to be much in them. Gosh dang it. So does anyone know? Or can anyone tell me? Do I need to go find another pyramid now? Only one pharaoh per pyramid. Okay. In that case then, let's do a slash home and let's go through the portal again. And let's go find another pyramid. 1, 2, 3, and 4. He is dead. That wasn't too bad at all, actually. That was not bad at all. There's our second sarcophagus there. I will take some of this. Tombstone Soulbound. I'll take this guy. And I guess I'll also take these as well. Not sure if they're going to be particularly useful, but we'll take them. And yeah, that is that pretty much done. Nice. Let me dump some of my inventory here, because we are holding on to a lot of stuff right now that we do not need to be holding on to. All the time. We only have 18 coins. I don't know how we're going to go about getting those last two coins, actually. Oh, we get a choice reward. Ooh, okay. I'll have to come back to this because I don't know, like, if any of those are useful. More recipes have been unlocked. Do we unlock a recipe to make the coins, maybe? We don't. You can, however, mine relic ore. 0.04% chance. Oofed. So how do I go about getting coins here? It says, thank you for playing Antimatter Chemistry. To access our brand new exclusive uber cool mega awesome chapter 4, you will need to purchase our DLC for only 1995 coins while supplies last. And then we get the chapter 4 DLC. So do I have to go and find relic ore? Pretty sure they have a chance to drop from enemies. Really? Let's go do a quick check on that. Let's kill a few more of the guys that are wandering around and see if we can't get... Oh, they do drop from them. Yeah, there's 20 right out of the gate. Perfect. All right, goodbye, my friend. I am going home again. Okay, I will buy the DLC. Got him. All right, so that's that bit taken care of, chat. So now we can look at making brown antimatter, which we get from neodymium, which I believe we can also use to make enderpearls, I think? Yeah, we can, with silicon and mercury. So we might be getting close to that there. But we can also use it, of course, to make brown antimatter. The neodymium we can get from limestone, which you can go and mine in quite large quantities over in the tomb dimension. And then we can look at getting a deep learner, a deep mob learning simulation chamber and loot fabricator, and then look at getting some pristine matter from those. And then heading over through to the end. So we're about to fight the dragon fairly soon. Interesting. And then we can look at chapter 5 and 6 with some draconic evolution and some nuclear craft. Which is going to be interesting for sure. Yeah, so like I said, I think between streams, I will maybe move this. Although I might just set up, like, I don't know how hard it's going to be for us to make a draw controller. I actually don't think it's going to be that difficult. So what I might just do is just make a new draw controller. Yeah, it's actually very easy because we have nether quartz and diamonds. I might just set up a new draw controller and have like a little draw system specifically for mob drops. We do also probably want to look at setting up some kind of trash can system to delete certain items like these bows here, because we don't really want to be keeping those going forward. We do actually get ender pearls from them as well, which is very nice indeed. And we also get a plethora of loot crates. I assume that we maybe can auto open loot crates. Ooh, and a speedy hopper 3, nice. I assume we can maybe auto open loot crates with like a mechanical user maybe, which might be something we need to look into doing, because we are going to get so many of them that opening them by hand seems like it might be a little, you know, tedious. But yeah, there's also a few more quests up here to do with the 2 mod, but I think, chat, that is where I'm going to go ahead and wrap up today's stream.